Hello viewers, welcome to weekly MBTV Property Roundup. We bring to you top developments from Indian real estate space, which is going to have a lasting impact on you as a consumer. I am Prasoon Kumar, Marketing Head of Magic Bricks, and with me is Jayashree Kuru, Senior Real Estate Journalist and Editor-in-Chief of MBTV. Welcome, Jayashree.
Thanks, Prasoon.
So Jayashree, progressive legislations is something that we have been batting for, and we have reported quite a lot of them happening in past year or so specifically. Now, one such legislation happened in Karnataka recently, where the Karnataka Assembly passed the BBMP bill, which is Brihat Bengaluru Mahanagar Palika, which provides for expanding municipal limits of the city, increasing number of wards and increasing the term of the mayor and so on and so forth. Now, this is considered a significant step. How is it going to help consumers at large, citizens at large, and what is the significance of this therefore?
Prasoon, this is a very significant piece of local legislation. Historically, our cities did not have the wherewithal to manage themselves. And even though we had a mayor and elected government, you know, the councillors, they didn't have very many powers. And it was very, you know, they depended on the doles given by the states. And there has been a consistent call by experts that we should allow the cities, the third tier of governance, to function as independent authorities. Mm. Now, this was also the 74th amendment to the constitution, which was passed over maybe a decade and a half or two. But it was never implemented because the states were very reluctant to give control of the cities to city authorities. And then what happens is that, you know, unless the state decides that there is money to be given or some work to be done, the cities could never do anything. So the mayor became a very titular role, and with a mostly 1 year tenure. And that's not enough to actually pass any legislation or things like that. What this law has done, this bill has done, is it has said that it will be a 2.5 year tenure. The number of wards will be increased, the city limits will be increased, and they are being allowed to generate revenue within the city, to rule the city. Now, I think in Bangalore did it the other way around. Bangalore, during the COVID times, the councillors stepped forward, the wards were strengthened. There are citizen volunteers who have been working with the BBMP to govern the health systems. So I think they've got their piece right, and then they pass this legislature saying that let Bangalore function as an independent entity.
It will become a self-sufficient entity now.
That's right. And hopefully the city governance will become better with this. And anyway, the cities, it's giving the one of the important things, Prasoon, something that we've been talking about, the RWAs have been acknowledged as the fourth tier of governance.
Right.
It's the center, the state, the city, and the RWAs, so that there is and at the ward level, it's the councillor that they owe their allegiance to. So I think it's a very, very significant move.
That's right. And any attempt to strengthen the municipality and local governance is always welcome.
Yeah.
Now, in continuation with consumer-friendly measures that are being taken in real estate, Jayashree, and lots of judgments of various courts have also come in favor of consumers. Now, Bombay High Court recently passed a judgment where they said in a related case that delay in approvals cannot be covered under force majeure conditions by developers and cannot be a reason to deny timely possession to home buyers. Again, a very, very significant judgment.
Yeah. First of all, force majeure means an act of God.
That's right.
The authorities are not God. So if the authorities have delayed the processes, you have, even the developers could have walked up to RERA and made the complaints that these completion details are not coming in.
Yeah.
The developers, it's not the developers have not been late. They have also been late. So this just compounded the delay.
Yeah.
But you can't deny the consumer. For the consumer, your contract is between the developer and the consumer. Now, if you've signed a contract saying that I will give it to you in 36 months or 48 months or something like that, you have to factor in the delays. And that is the developer's job. So I think it's a very good move that the High Court has said that you cannot invoke force majeure because a file did not move. Make it move. That's your job, right?
Absolutely. Now, moving up north, Jayashree, in Greater Noida, the Greater Noida authority now seems to have decided to take over the stuck housing projects. Now, is this really going to help home buyers? Are they really going to go after redeveloping these or developing these and therefore delivering to home buyers? What is this all about?
Prasoon, let's look at the track record of all the development authorities across the country. They have been pathetic. Development authorities have not, if you take the Delhi Development Authority, has delivered in the last 5 decades, they've delivered about 4 lakh houses. A developer alone, a big developer alone has delivered way more than that. In much shorter periods. Development authorities are not the builder. Building is not their
presentation
and making sure that, you know, enablers, they should work like enablers.
Yeah.
What has happened is that the Greater Noida Authority has not invoked any of its rules for a long, long time. Now, when the developers are unable to complete the projects and they have gone to NCLT, suddenly it realizes that it has to take significant haircuts and it has pushed itself forward as a developer. I think this is the worst thing that can happen. It should be facilitating, it should be enabling, it should make sure that projects move forward, but cannot be the constructor of the projects.
No, absolutely. And it always has options of bodies like NBCC or other such bodies to really invite and take over the stuck housing projects and build them.
And RERA's also facilitate implementation.
Yes, absolutely. Now, in Gurugram nearby, Jayashree, DTCP, which is Department of Town and Country Planning, has announced that it's going to resolve 100 complaints related to illegal colonies in the month. Now, much is reported and said also about illegal structures and illegal colonies, especially in Delhi NCR, in and around Gurgaon and Arauli region and everything else. Has there been any progress in terms of really putting a check on that? And what is this resolving compliance means actually?
Actually, Prasun, in Gurgaon, any good move starts with a good officer. There is a bunch of good officers who have been working towards at least eliminating the grabbing of land. And we have seen a lot of structures being demolished, land being reclaimed and so on. This is the, as a result, I think there is more confidence among the buyers that you can, they have been posting on the CM window. There's another reason for this kind of legislation, because the small builders who were pushed out of the system because of compliance-related issues and because RERA had come and was insisting on compliance, they went to the smaller units, which is the less than 500 square yards unit, which is not monitored by RERA. And there has been rampant overbuilding, vacant land grabbing and things like that. Many colonies, you know, plotted colonies across Gurgaon, and it was primarily a plotted colony in the beginning. So you have DLF 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4. There's Sushant Lok 1 and 2. There's South City 1 and 2, Sun City. A lot of plotted layouts that were there. The small developers have gotten, and there is no governance at all. So the consumers have started complaining to the authorities. And I think they have promised that at least 100 per month will be resolved. Let's take that as a placeholder and say that at least 100 will be resolved, which is not bad.
Yeah, sure. And the point is, Jayashree, any such institution that is set up as a check and balance in the system largely depends on the officers manning it anyway, right? And we also see examples in RERA. Wherever there are good officers in RERA and are actively driving things, you see RERA being very proactive and doing a lot of things, and consumers really getting a lot of reprieve, otherwise. But there are also examples of other RERA which are not as functioning or, you know, much is desired to be done there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Haryana government has also directed all the registered housing societies to upload their records on website. Now, you know, taking a much larger view on this, Jayashree, we have been speaking about digitization and why digitization is important, especially in real estate. And there has been a massive digitization of land records that has been happening, and we have been reporting all of that. Now, this is another step forward in that direction, and really something that every single state and every single municipality should follow.
Yeah, slowly it is from digitization of just land records. And remember that bulk of the digitization has happened in rural records rather than urban records. Mm-hmm. This is one step further where they are saying at least wherever there is aggregated groups of residents, mm-hmm. that's that online. So this is aggregation of digitization of property records. Mm-hmm. Slowly we're moving towards a system where every property will have its own unique ID. But it's a long way off till there is concrete steps taken. And each of these things are, you know, one more piece in the jigsaw puzzle. Mm-hmm. You'll have to, we are a long way off from every property being identified and digitized, but this is moving towards that direction. Sure.
And alongside digitization of land records, what is also important that all the amenities that are provided, by authorities and public sector units are also modernized at the same point of time. And a step in that direction probably was taken by Greater Noida Authority, who have decided to install smart water meters now across all the societies, because much water was being extracted from the ground and distributed, and that needs to be regulated as well.
See, water is a contentious issue across India. Whether it's Greater Noida the Authority, whether it's Gurugram, which has taken over the private colonies, by the developers, or whether it is in Bengaluru, where metering is becoming a big deal. Yeah. Ultimately, you have to supply 24/7 water if you have to conserve water. If you have regular water and good quality of water, then there will be less storage and then upsetting that stored water and so on. So the consumption patterns become less. So India is trying to move towards that. And private developers, when they build, it has not been mandatory that they should get the water meters installed before they hand over. This used to happen in big cities like Bangalore and Delhi, but the peripheral cities that are governed by developers, that modus operandi is not well functioning. And we are doing a big show on this on Thursday. And all consumers, I would invite them to come and participate in this show, because consumers need to understand what this means, metering of water. And it also means that, the quality of water and the efficiency of the metering is very important.
As well as digital supply.
Yes, that's right.
So, viewers, this is it for this week. We will again come back next week with important developments which are going to concern you. Till then, keep watching MBTV.
Thank you so much.